This consumer update is brought to you by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Sun safety is important for everyone, of all ages, in all seasons, and even on cloudy or hazy days. Here's how to protect yourself from harmful ultraviolet radiation when heading outdoors. Shield your skin from the sun by staying in the shade or wearing protective clothing. When staying in the shade or covering up are not options, apply sunscreen to all areas of your skin that will be exposed to the sun.
With sunscreen, it's important to read the label and apply the recommended amount evenly to all uncovered skin, especially your lips, nose, ears, neck, hands, and feet. Make sure to use sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or more. SPF stands for Sun Protection Factor. The higher the number, the better the protection.
Everyone ages 6 months and up needs sunscreen. Ask a doctor before applying sunscreen to children younger than 6 months. Apply sunscreen 15 minutes before going out in the sun, and remember to reapply it every 2 hours. If you have little or no hair, be sure to wear a cap or hat. If you can't wear a hat, apply sunscreen to the top of your head, and remember to protect your eyes.
Everyone needs sunglasses for protection. Sunlight, reflecting off snow, sand, and water, increases exposure to UV radiation, raising the risk of eye injury, including cataracts and blindness.
When buying sunglasses, make sure the label says that the lenses provide 99 to 100% UV protection. A darker tint does not mean better protection. For better protection, wear sunglasses that wrap around your temples. These block sunlight that can enter from the sides. Children need sunglasses too. Read the label to make sure their sunglasses also provide 99 to 100% UV protection. And for safety, polycarbonate lenses are the most shatter resistant.
Not all sunglasses are equal. Darker is not better, and more expensive does not equal more protection. If the label doesn't show that your sunglasses provide 99 to 100% UV protection, get yourself a pair that does.
For more information on this and other health topics, go to www.fda.gov/consumer.